everybody. My name is José Menaroldán, and I'm going to present a paper that we did together with my professors, Uriel Pujol and Jordi Vitria, about how to measure the performance of a classification API in a given problem. So these days there is this concept of machine learning as a service, where companies are delivering AI services as APIs. You can find APIs for almost everything, for detecting sentiment in text or tagging images, translating documents, etc. So as a practitioner, it's a sensible choice when you start developing a new system to use one of these APIs. So for example, sometimes you don't have enough data for training your model, or you are in a hurry and you want something that is ready out of the box, or sometimes you don't have the resources, or maybe you are aware of the climate emergency and you don't want to train a model that emits as much carbon as 5 cars, no? As I heard the other day. So for example, take this use case where you have a data set of movie reviews that you want to classify on whether they are positive or negative. So you look for an existing sentiment analysis API, and you end up with one that was trained for reviews about restaurants that are rated from 1 to 5 stars. No? So in this case, both the domain and also the categories that the classifier is offering you are different from your problem. No? So to which extent are we going to trust this classifier, or is a better idea to train our own model, no, based on our data? To give you an intuition of the method that we propose here, imagine that we have this a classifier that was trained with using the data at the left. So we have 3 classes corresponding to 3 points. And then we take this classifier as a black box, and we want to apply it to our data set there at the right. So note that the classifier, when applied to our problem, classifies our data set, but note that there is a new mass of points that are class 2 points that will be wrongly classified as class 1, there at the bottom right. So when using a classifier, especially a probabilistic classifier, they will give you a probability of for each of the categories. So you can use this probability as a measure of the confidence of the classifier if well calibrated. So you will be able to detect the uncertainties at the decision boundaries, where the zones where the classifier is less secure of the decisions that is delivering. However, note that the new mass of points that were that belong to our data set are not being detected as uncertain, because they have a very confident prediction while a very wrong one. Okay? So at the picture at the right, we are presenting the results of applying our method. So note that we still are able to detect the uncertainty associated to the decision boundaries, but also we are detecting the new conflicting points at the bottom right that were wrongly classified. So also the method that we are preparing, that we are presenting here, we have to recall that we are dealing with black boxes, so we have no knowledge about the internals of the model that we are using, the API. So we only have access to the input and to the output of the classifier. So what we do, how we measure this uncertainty? Well, what we do is we transform this prediction. So remember, for example, the classifier that was telling us whether a movie review is positive or negative, and we transform, for example, a prediction of 80% of being positive to a distribution of probabilities. This distribution of probabilities will be around this 80%, but we have a beta parameter that is equalizing this prediction that will give us a sense of how certain the prediction is. So by taking a small fraction of the data set, the target data set that we have, we can train this beta parameter that will give us this probability distribution. Then afterwards, by sampling this distribution, we will have a measure of the uncertainty for every prediction. Okay? So once we have this uncertainty score, what we can do is we can, if we go for using the API, we can go for start using this uncertainty. So what we do is we sort the predictions from more to less uncertain, and we start rejecting those predictions that are less confident to us. So if the hypothesis that uncertain predictions correspond to erroneous ones, as we start rejecting predictions that are uncertain, we will increase the performance of the resulting classifier. So in the paper, we did the different experiments using the sentiment analysis data sets from Yelp reviews to IMDb reviews, also for products from Amazon. So here you can see some results where the green line corresponds to using our uncertainty for rejecting predictions, and the blue line will be using the confidence score. So you can see that only by rejecting 20% of the more uncertain predictions, we can increase the accuracy of the resulting classifier in more than 8 points. And also by looking at some qualitative results, we can see that when analyzing, in this case, applying a classifier that was trained for restaurants to movie reviews, we can see that beyond the ambiguous text that can lead to uncertain predictions, the more interesting example will be the last one, where we have a review that says that has that rare quality of being able to creep the living hell out of you. So for a movie, for a horror movie, this will be a positive review. But remember that we train it for restaurants. So so it will be problematic. Okay, so to wrap up, we presented a way to assess the performance of a classification API based on the uncertainty of the predictions. And we saw how using this uncertainty can be also a good way to increase the performance of the resulting classifier. Thank you.